Hey guys, what's up? So I'm back and I've emptied out the bags and this is what came out of them. All of it needs to be washed. And I'll explain why in a second. But some really, really great clothes, some awesome shoes. There's actually a brand new pair of shoes right there. And some hats, some beanies. And then over there in that bag there is some stuff that I just cannot use. These clothes came from my niece. And I guess it is a friend who, or someone she knows. I doubt that this is her friend. It's just somebody she knows, and apparently this gentleman who I never met had cancer and he died. My niece told me a little bit. Is this crooked? If it is, guys, I'm sorry. My niece told me a little bit, because I was wondering if all these clothes came from the same person because of... That's crooked. Because of the different sizes and things. And, so she explained to me that, he had been sick and it gotten sicker and he had colon cancer and then breast cancer, which I believe is very rare in men. But he felt a lump under his arm and he thought it was a boil and went in to get it checked out and they admitted him into a hospital and he never came home after that. He went from the hospital to a convalescent place, then to a hospice. And earlier tonight when my niece was here, I was like pulling some of the stuff out and I was like, wow, this stuff is really, really great. I did run past a pair of basketball shorts. And when I pulled them out, I saw something on them and I just thought, I'll just throw them into the pile. And I threw them into the pile. And then when I picked them back up to start sorting them, what I saw was, from the outside of the short, it looked like poo, like he pooped on himself. But when you pull the short open, I could tell that it was blood. So immediately, just got rid of those immediately. And then there was like some personal stuff in here. And then that's when I really got curious. And I was just like, wow, did anybody care for this guy? He had a girlfriend. Did she not go through this stuff? Well, right after I shot the first video, I was going through stuff and folding stuff, and then I dumped open another bag, and it just made me cry. And it made me think about my own situation. How this was a life. It was like his bedding, I guess, from the hospice. That was just... it was just rolled up into like this big ball and it had towels in it, and when I shook it open, it was just covered in blood. And then that's when it really, really hit me that this isn't a simple donation. This came from someone who is dead. And when I started to, I immediately had to like go like sterilize my hands and get gloves and get this stuff into a bag. And as I was putting it into the bag, stuff were falling out, like notes he had written, pencils, his toothbrush. And it just looks like, well, he's dead. Let's get this bed ready for the next person. Let's get this spot ready for the next person. No respect whatsoever for his personal things. And so I called my niece. And I asked her again, hey, what happened to this guy? And she explained a little bit more. And I just started crying because I was like going through his stuff, thinking that they didn't even care enough about this man to give him any dignity and respect. They didn't even care enough about him to throw the stuff away that needed to go in the trash. They just took his things and threw it into one fucking bag. The guy that had this apartment before me died. And just seeing this stuff and how his stuff was treated with such disrespect. Really just made me think about my own situation. If I get sick, who's gonna take care of me? If I have to go to a hospice, who's gonna check on me? And I call my niece and I start talking to my niece and I just broke down. Because the reality, I know I'm sick, but the reality of just dying alone set in. They just took his stuff and just crammed it into a bag. Stuff that's like covered in blood. They just took his toiletries and they just crammed it into these trash bags. So I asked my niece, I go, what did his girlfriend say? How come she didn't complain? And she was just like, well, she said when she got there, they had had his stuff all packed up. I think his name was Derek. In fact, I'm sure it's Derek because on one of the notes it had his name on it. Derek, I'm gonna give your clothes the respect that I give clothes that I get from people who are living. I'm gonna wash them and clean them, and they're gonna go to people who need them. They're gonna go to good use. When I see how your things were treated, your personal belongings, when I see how they were treated, it just makes me wonder how you were treated. Did you receive dignity and respect and positive touch as you were there in that hospice? I will treat your things with respect, and I will make sure they go to people who could really, really use them. And God, I know you're listening. So please give this message to Derek. Let him know that I care. My niece cares. And other people care. And that as things are going to people who need them. This was just... This really just brought my whole night down. How do you